Hello students, welcome to RD Chemistry. If you are watching for the first time, please do subscribe, like the videos and share the videos. In this video, I will explain stability of coordination compounds. To what extent these complexes are stable in the solution, we are going to study in terms of stability constant. So let us start now. Consider complex of the type ML4. M stand for the metal, L stand for the ligand. Four ligands are there, therefore coordination number is equal to 4, and these ligands are unidentate ligand. Now let me write down the reaction between metal and the four ligands. It will give the complex ML4 as the product. Since we are carrying out this one in the solution state, let there be equilibrium. Whenever there is equilibrium, we write down equilibrium constant. Let me write down equilibrium constant the beta, which is equal to the product concentration ML4 concentration by the square bracket. Okay, this divided by metal concentration into the ligand concentration to the power 4, because 4 moles are there. Correct? Now what is the meaning of stability of the complex? Stability of the complex means it is a degree of association. Associate metal and the ligand. Degree of association of the two species, these two species, reactant species, which is involved in the equilibrium state. Okay? Now this equilibrium constant is also called as the stability constant. It is also called as the stability constant, which means as the more and more product is formed, complex is formed, beta value goes on increases, which means it is more toward the product side. More toward the product side means the more stable is the complex formed. Okay. Now, will this reaction take place in a single step? No, it can take place in four different steps. Okay. So, what will happen in the first step? Metal will react with the first ligand and in equilibrium with the ML. This is the first species that is formed, intermediate. Okay. Now, here also there is equilibrium. Let me write the equilibrium constant K1 here, which is equal to product concentration divided by the reactant concentration, metal and the ligand here. Okay. First step. Second step. In the second step, the product form reacts with the one more ligand to give ML2. Okay. For this, K2 is equal to ML2 divided by the metal ligand complex into ligand here. Third one, ML2 product intermediate reacts with the one more ligand to give the intermediate, third intermediate, ML3. For this, let it be K3, which is equal to ML3 divided by the concentration of the ML2 into the concentration of the ligand here. Last step, ML3 reacts with the last ligand available to give the complex ML4. Okay. Therefore, I can write K4 is equal to ML4 concentration divided by ML3 concentration into the ligand concentration. Okay. So, what are K1, K2, K3, K4? These K1, K2, K3, K4 are the stability constants also. Okay. But for the different steps, therefore, they are called the stepwise stability constant. Stepwise stability constant. Clear? Now, what is beta? Beta actually stands for overall stability constant. How many steps are there? Four steps are there. Therefore, write beta 4. Okay? So, beta refers to the overall stability constant involving all the steps together, and K1, K2, K3, K4 for the stepwise it is. So, I can write beta 4 is equal to K1 into K2 into K3 into K4. Okay, can be written using the equilibrium concepts. Or suppose there are n steps are there, then I'll write K1 into K2 into up to the last step Kn here. Clear? Right? I said beta 4 is called as the overall stability constant, right? Overall stability constant. Clear? Overall stability constant. This stability constant is also called the formation constant. Formation constant. Okay, we are forming the complex. So it is a formation constant. Now we'll see what is the dissociation constant. Dissociation constant. Or instability constant. Instability constant. I have written previously the reaction to form ML4. Reverse reaction is known as the dissociation reaction, correct? So the constant for the dissociation, backward reaction, the dissociation constant, which is equal to, it is equal to 1 divided by the overall stability constant or formation constant or formation constant or the formation constant. If I apply the same, okay, equation, then I would write 1 divided by beta 4. Okay, remember, instability constant is a reciprocal of formation constant. So dissociation constant or instability constant is reciprocal of, what is this? It is the reciprocal of the formation constant, beta 4. Formation constant. Let me write a beta in general n, whether it is a 2 steps, 3 steps, 4 steps. Clear? Now, based on this, we'll solve one simple problem which is there in the NCERT textbook. Solved one, right? Yeah. Read this question. Calculate the overall dissociation constant for the complex CuNH3 4 times and plus 2 charge. Beta 4 for this complex is given 2.1 into 10 power 13. What is beta 4? Beta 4 stands for the formation constant or the stability constant, correct? And we are supposed to calculate dissociation constant. Dissociation formation are reciprocal of each other. Therefore, I can calculate dissociation constant. So, dissociation constant is the reciprocal of, is equal to 1 divided by reciprocal of beta 4. Correct? So, which is equal to 1 divided by beta 4, 2.1 into 10 power 13, which is equal to, so it is a 1 divided by 2.1 approximately comes to be 0.47. into 10 power minus 13 becomes, correct? Or it can be written as a 4.7 into 10 to the power minus 14 it becomes. Clear? Very simple, correct? Right? Now let us see what are the applications and the importance of these coordination compounds in our day-to-day life. Okay? First one, the pigment responsible for photosynthesis, which is known as the chlorophyll, is a coordination compound of magnesium. Remember, chlorophyll contains magnesium, Mg. Second one, red pigmentation of the blood, hemoglobin, is a coordination compound of iron. Remember, hemoglobin contains iron, Fe. Next one, vitamin B12 is a cyanocobalamin, is a coordination compound of cobalt. Cobalt is a CO. EDTA, ethylene diamine, tetraacetic acid or tetraacetate, used in the treatment of lead poisoning, because lead will complexes with the EDTA, which can be removed. Okay. The platinum complex, cisplatin, is a cis isomer. Cis and trans is there, no? Therefore, they are taking the cis. Okay. Cisplatin, used to inhibit growth of tumors. Rhodium complex, pH. pH stands for phenyl, benzene. Okay? It is benzene. pH stands for benzene. Triphenyl. pH is benzene. Phenyl. Triphenyl, rhodium, and Cl, chloride ligand. This is a Wilkinson catalyst used for the hydrogenation of alkenes. Next one. Hardness of water is estimated by simple titration using disodium salt of the EDTA. and calcium ions and magnesium ions will complexes with the EDTA to form more stable complexes. Last one, in black and white photography, developed film is fixed by washing hypo solution, which dissolves undecomposed silver bromide to form the complex ion. Ag is the central metal atom and H2O3 two times and overall charge is 3. It forms this complex. Clear? So these are the some applications of the coordination compounds in day-to-day life. Like the videos, share the videos, and please do subscribe RD Chemistry, and thank you for watching.